VA-2021-09.
Madam Chairman, the next two requests is an annexation and a rezoning. For the tradition and for simplicity's sake, we'll do one discussion, one public hearing for both cases. And then when it comes time to make motion to vote, we do that with the rezoning first.
Right.
And then the annexation. So this one is, this has to be a fairly easy one. But it's annexation and rezoning of a piece of property that is sort of somewhat isolated. It is from R-21 and highway commercial in the county to highway commercial in the city. City limit line does not show up very well here, which you can see it's all the same parent area. But the aerial image paints the story a little bit better. You see the subject property outlined in yellow. Immediately to the south and southwest, you see the extension of long rectangles. And then you see the rooftops and the truck trailers of a truck stop. That's an existing truck stop that has been there for many years. This truck stop consists of several parcels of land, most of which are already in the city limits. What you see outlined in yellow is the only part that is not in the city limits. The property is proposed to change hands and be completely demolished and rebuilt as a new truck stop facility by RaceTrac. And as part of that process, we're trying to get all of their parcels into the city as one tract of land. So this is the last puzzle piece of the property that's still not in the city limits. I remember over the past 25 or more years, we had different zoning cases, even a couple of annexations. This is a truck stop that has been piecemealed over time as it expanded. And this is finally the last piece, and then everything gets redeveloped at once. So it's simply the backyard behind one of the existing buildings to be annexed and rezoned, then to be combined with everything else. In your packet is a survey site plan that shows existing conditions. As you see here, sort of reflected in the aerial, those northerly reaches of the site, those different parcels are consumed by wetlands. The lines you see running east-west across there, that's the drainage easement for Georgia DOT. It deals with the drainage from I-75 that cuts through part of the property that is not developable. Of course, even the new truck stop can stay away from that. Zooming in on the proposed site plan, very similar in overall layout and scale as the existing truck stop, but a better design. And certainly a newer version of what is there now. Same number of gas pumps, same number of diesel pumps. A larger convenience store building. One interesting thing to note is that the existing, you can see more in the aerial, that building on the back corner is a truck repair facility. That will go away. So you will have more of a conventional truck stop, warmer maneuvering room for the trucks, and certainly a lot better organized site. Photographs, subject property as you see it from Hill Avenue. This is the Hill Avenue frontage. You see the gas station pumps for cars on the right, the truck pumps on the left, some truck parking behind. The entrance is actually Briarwood, where the trucks come in off of US 84. That will continue to be the same. And then the subject property is actually this open area that is directly behind that repair facility that is taking back toward Hill Avenue. And then further up Briarwood, we go back to the development plan. So again, the new facility here to replace what's there now, but to do that, they need to get out under one jurisdiction, one parcel line, against the annexation rezoning request. So with that, staff is recommending approval of finding both consistent with the comprehensive plan and the rezoning consistent with our stance for exercise of zoning power, design zoning, compliance zoning, and we're recommending.
Okay. Fantastic. Do we have questions for staff? I don't know about y'all, but I'm kind of missing Commissioner Bailey tonight on these questions. All right. With that, we'll open it up to the public. Is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak on behalf of this request?
Mike Dale, 701 North Patterson. I am very excited to represent RaceTrac. I live right down the street from this area, and I feel like this is an excellent opportunity for the City of Valdosta. It's a wonderful company, and Matt did an excellent job summarizing the technical aspects of this. It's one of Ali is here with me. He's representative of RaceTrac. He's prepared a presentation to put through some slides and show you what good and what good look like. Happy to answer any questions that you'll have for me. Thank you. I'll be best if I just turn it over to Ali and Mr. Ali.
That sounds great. Thank you,
Chad.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, and Chad. Good evening, Mr. Ali.
Good evening.
If you could please state your full name and address.
Sami Ali, 200
okay.
Bellevue Parkway, Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you, Mr. Martin, and good evening, the board. I just wanted to give a brief presentation about RaceTrac, our company, and some description about the building that we're bringing here to the City of Valdosta. So RaceTrac is located in Atlanta, Georgia, where we have about 550 RaceTrac stores throughout the southeast in 8 states. We do operate as a 24-hour operating store and our own biofamily business. We offer fresh food, pizza, fried chicken, free coffee for government employees, as well as frozen yogurt. We do provide a well-lit, safe environment, and we pride ourselves in our clean and organized experience that we have at our stores. Community contributions, our development brings about 20 to 25 corporate jobs at each site, as well as $4 to $15 million real estate investment at each site, this one being a little more on the higher end. You want the next slide? This is a site plan that Mr. Martin shared. It's slightly been adjusted. One driveway on Briarwood, the one close to the intersection, has been shut down due to a GDOT's request. So we removed that, but the overall site plan is still remaining the same. And then moving on to the next slide, this is an example elevation of the front and rear of the building. The rear of the building has access to all the truck traffic that we'll be bringing directly from the diesel canopies. This is also an example rendering. We do offer outdoor patio seating for all our customers, and just another elevation for you guys to view. And lastly, this is what our canopy looks like. We have a red, white, and blue canopy fascia. And yeah, this is what the front and the back court would look like. Any questions?
What about overnight parking for the trucks and stuff?
So we do not offer overnight amenities as showers or any truck maintenance, but there's nothing that we do that restricts overnight parking. So if a trucker, let's say, uses all his miles by 11 p.m. that night, he is allowed to stay, but we do have a 24-hour restriction. You can't park more than 24 hours.
You said there won't be showers at this facility.
No, ma'am.
Are there at any of your facilities?
No, not yet.
Okay.
These are the first of a few travel centers, so not yet.
Okay. Because I know you guys just recently opened one at like exit 102 on 75 around Cordial.
Okay.
No shower facilities.
No showers,
okay.
Yeah. We're not there yet.
Okay. All righty. Do we have any questions? All right. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
All right. Is there anyone else that would like to speak on behalf of this request? We have a couple of minutes. All right, if not, is there anyone wishing to speak against this request? All right, if there's no one wishing to speak against, we'll turn it back over to the commissioners. Is there any discussion? If not, I'll call for the motion. Commissioner Willis?
VA-2021-09. Is consistent with the comprehensive plan standards of which site zoning powers, and I make a motion we recommend to the City Council.
All right, this is the motion on 2021-09 to rezone.
That's the first one, correct?
Right. All right, we have a motion to approve. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Commissioner Hightower. All right, any discussion? All those in favor of the motion to approve the rezoning request, please raise your right hand. Alrighty. All those against? Motion carries. So now we'll be looking at a motion for the annexation. If we have no questions for staff, this will be 2021-10, the annexation request of the same property.
Madam Chair.
Yes, Commissioner Wiles.
Regarding VA-2021-10 for the annexation of this property we're discussing, I'd like to make a motion that we recommend to the city council.
All right. We have a motion to approve. Do I have a second?
Second.
I call Commissioner Miller first on that one. All right. Is there any discussion on the motion? All those in favor of the motion to approve the annexation request, please raise your right hand. All those against, motion carries unanimously.